Even did y'all hear? Even Mandisa went bomb, bomb, bomb. She was even singing along, yeah. Caroline. She's a true overcomer. Our great friend, Grammy-winning artist Mandisa. She helped welcome me back, as you may remember, to GMA with her hit song "Stronger" in 2013. That was following my bone marrow transplant, and she has been a source of comfort and inspiration for so many people. I remember that like it was yesterday. My sisters were here, and I'm just one of many who said, thank you. You helped so many of us overcome. Please welcome an overcomer herself, Mandisa, back
here. Thank you. Wow.
Yeah.
I told you not to make me cry.
No, I said they're going to be tears of joy.
Yeah.
That song also, your song Overcomer, the video, and people remember it and they saw it, and it was for your friend Keisha.
Mm-hmm.
And when she passed away from breast cancer, you lost it.
You went
into deep depression.
Yeah.
Tell people what happened. And it's so ironic because that was a song that helped so many people.
Yes, and I remember when I asked you to be in it, and oh gosh, y'all are really trying to make me cry.
No.
That is Keisha, wow. And I remember telling you about her when I was here and really believing and praying that God was going to heal her. And so when she passed away, it just shook the foundation underneath me in a way that I didn't expect. And I've never been the kind of person that shakes my fist and yells at God. I'm the kind of person who shuts down. And I told Jen, Dr. Jen, amazing that you just had that segment here about emotional eating, because that is what I have done my entire life. And so after losing over 120 pounds, which I talked about my first time here, I gained it all back and 75 more. And so I sunk into the deepest depression of my life after Keisha
You
passed.
Would not let friends in. People would be knocking at your door. You would put earplugs in. You'd shut people out.
I did. That is kind of, I think, growing up, you know, living with just my mom and growing up isolated a lot and being super single. If you're a big black born again believer with a bald head and a goatee, call me. But being super single, it's so easy for me to shut everybody out and to just be by myself. And I've learned how dangerous that is.
Yes, you did, because you said you were going down a very dark road.
It got pretty bad to the point where if I had not gotten off that road, I would not be sitting here today. I was this close to listening to that voice that told me, you can be with Jesus right now, Mandisa. All you have to do is take your life. And it almost happened, but God is what I say.
Yeah.
He saved my life, quite literally.
Yeah, he stepped in, your friend stepped in, love stepped in. I've often said, you know, when people ask, you know, was your faith shaken? And they said the same to me. And I said, I got mad at him, but he can take it.
Yeah, that's
right.
God,
he can take it. He can take it. Just don't stay mad.
Yeah.
Tell people how your friends, you were at a movie, because that was a dark place, and you watched movie after movie.
Yeah.
When you came out of the movie, what did you find in your car?
So I came out of the movie theater. This was after years of me being in that dark place and ignoring everybody. And I noticed that my car had a bunch of sticky notes all over it. And as I got closer to it, I realized that those notes said things like, we love you, come back to us, we miss you. And then as I got closer to my car, a group of my friends who I'd shut out, they were there, and they had been waiting at that movie theater as I sat there and watched two movies, not just one. They waited there for over 4 hours for me, and they pretty much had an intervention, and they said, we love you just as you are, but we love you too much to leave you that way.
Oh, gosh, and I'm so glad that they were there for you. And, you know, you have been, this is what is so ironic, you have been there for so many people. Thank you for allowing us to finally be there for you. It means so much. And your new music, which you're going to hear in the next half hour, you're going to hear her new music. Oh, yes, 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 yes. You're allowing yourself to be transparent. You're letting us in.
Totally. Yeah, I realize as I started to share this story, I started to hear from people who said, I'm just glad to know I'm not alone, and then I'm not the only one who felt that way. And so the album that's coming out May 19th, it's called Out of the Dark, because that is where God has lifted me out of. And the song I'm gonna sing, it's called Unfinished, because I realize I don't have to be perfect and have it all together, that I'm a masterpiece in the making. I'm just unfinished for right now.
Yes, indeed. And we're gonna hear that coming out. But you're in a good place now. You're in a good place.
I've never been better, honestly. And I'm not where I want to be, but
okay.
Thank God I'm not where I was. And I have lost, you know, about 75 of the weight that I gained, but I'm going to get all the way there.
Not finished yet.
That's great.
Not finished yet. All right. You are going to be back in the next Thank you for sharing that. We'll be right back. Mandisa.